am really in love with this first project, and what I used was this hanging light bulb, some batteries from the dollar store, and then the additional supplies were just some yarn and a hot glue gun, and I did use a little bit of spray paint. So I found this hanging LED light bulb. Of course, it was just a dollar. You open it up, you insert a couple of batteries in there, and then basically what you do is you pull the string and the light bulb lights up. And this light isn't super bright, but it's actually, I tested at nighttime, it's like a perfect reading light. So if you were to have it by your bed or something, it's a great thing to just like pull on and basically read with, or whatever you want to do with it. And so what I started off by doing was just masking off the actual light bulb area, because originally I was going to put yarn around this area, but I wanted it to be able to have the batteries removed and put back in if they needed to be changed. So I ended up just using a 14 karat brass spray paint, which you guys all know my love for this spray paint. I think it looks so good. It really transforms anything and makes it look so expensive. So I sprayed the little battery slot piece and then also the other piece. And what I'm now doing is creating the cord for it. So I'm just creating a loop initially, as you can see on the screen here. And what I'm doing is a chain stitch. So I'm just putting my two fingers through and then pulling through the excess yarn. And the excess yarn is actually just attached to the entire like little ball of yarn, I guess you could say. And I'm just pulling it through and sort of creating this chain. And the reason I'm doing this is because I didn't just want to hang my LED light. I don't know why I'm calling it LED light. My light bulb, essentially, just from a piece of yarn. I thought that was boring. I really wanted to create more of like a cording or a rope. So that's exactly what I'm doing here. And this is super easy. It took me like maybe 3 minutes to make a 2 foot long section of this. You can go really, really quick. After you get the hang of it, it goes really quickly. So I just pulled through and created this nice little chain stitch yarn piece, which is going to act as a cord. And when you get to the end, all you need to do is cut off and then put that tail end through the loop and pull it. And that actually just finishes off your chain stitch there. And this is going to be the cording that I'm going to be using for my hanging light. And then what I'm doing is just pulling off that little masking area with the tape and the paper towel, and this reveals the look. And then I just cut that black string, because the black string was just kind of ugly. It wasn't my favorite thing. And I glued onto the black string the cord that we created, and I made sure just to leave a little bit of excess black string hanging out. That way you have a lot to glue on, and there's a lot of like surface area for it to really stick and grasp onto. And lastly, just to finish off this project, I really wanted to wrap the corded section because I didn't like how the black string was showing. So I used a little bit of yarn and I just simply wrapped around this entire section, covering the cord that we created along with the black cord that was initially there. And you just have to do small sections of hot glue and just do small little wrappings each time. It's a little bit tedious, but once you finish it, it looks amazing. It looks very finished and polished. And honestly, this looks like it was made like at West Elm or created at Pottery Barn or something. It just looks really, really nice and pretty. And you can make these extremely long and hang them from the ceiling, whatever it may be. And you guys, honestly, this project probably cost me $1.50. So super affordable. All you have to do is pull a little cording and that turns your light on and you're good to go.